I once had a friend who told me that some things don't last forever. But the things that are meant to be together always piece themselves back. Melanie, this is for you.
Buzzy! Brother! Are you okay? Wait, you guys are brothers? Now, whatever. If you're gonna mess with the bee, you're gonna mess with me too, Buddy.
Ah. Lily's protege.
Huh? How did you...
Aw, what's the matter? Getting a sense of deja vu?
Oh, that deja vu just hit me like a ton of bricks.
Okay, Archie spent, what, like over a month canonically trying to get those stones? How did you get them within a week?
Well, it's rather simple, actually. All I had to do was invite you all to a banquet where I could extract them from you without notice. As for Puffy's, I got his when he died to Melanie's amulet.
Why do I explain things when you ask them to me? It's not your business. I'm evil. I got the stones back. Be scared.
You know, he brings up a valid point. Why do we ever tell anyone these things?
It doesn't matter if you have those stupid stones. In the grand scheme of things, that just means that our friends are safe now.
Well, that might be true, Skully. You all have pissed me off. And personally, I'm gonna squash you, Venkaria, the Netherlands City, and this entire goddamned kingdom until the rest of you are dead.
And I am gonna make my wife run!
Dimitri?
Yeah, Dimitri. I convinced him that our dad's an a-hole.
Why did it take so long for you to realize that?
Dimitri, get off of me!
No, I'm done holding on to the past. I'm done listening to you. Get out of here while you still can.
You don't have to tell me twice. Get on now. We're leaving.
I'm listening to Snowy. Let's get out of here, Zoggly.
Yeah, screw violence. That's kind of my plot anyways. Bye.
Alrighty, we're going too, Buzzy. Let's get out of here. Oh my gosh, for a bee, you're really, really heavy.
Why did Minecraft make them so big?
I'll just take that.
Alright. I guess we could always defeat him another day. We gotta go, guys, now!
I did not spend that long getting that staff, only for them to take it.
Face it, Darko, you're screwed! You shouldn't have messed with us!
Velly!
Phanty, you've done so much for me. You stuck with me even when I was an idiot, an asshole. I've changed. I've gone through a lot of growing, and I've realized something. All these stupid things I've done. Revenge? It's so pitiful. It's so stupid. I don't know why I ever wanted revenge. I don't care what William did to me. I don't care what my brother did to me. I'm done playing the bad guy. Go, Phanty. Take your brother and get out of here. And you too, Tabs.
What? No! No!
I said go! That is an order from your old boss.
I hope you know what you're doing, Endy.
We gotta go. He's given us the option to go, and we have no choice.
Trust me, I'd try and help if I was able to.
All right. Let's go.
Good luck, Endy. Mom would be proud.
I mean Lily. Why am I correcting myself? No one can even hear me.
So, it's just you and me.
Well, I suppose it is. You didn't have to leave.
You didn't have to leave this family.
We're on a never-ending cycle, Dad. You're just gonna continue down this path. How many people do you have to hurt just for Mom?
You know, that's the sweet irony. We're both cursed souls, and we're both seeking revenge for someone. When you think about it, you and I could not be any more alike, Endy.
Well, we'll see about that. Because there is one difference between you and I. You're a dead man walking for messing with my...
Stop! Please! Both of you, this has to stop! Endy. I'm sorry. For betraying you. For causing you to be cursed. For helping William. I'm sorry. I didn't mean it. I just wanted us to be a family. I was a child. I was like 8 or 9 when William told me to place that box in your room. I didn't know what I was getting myself into. I was scared. I missed Mom, and he promised that we'd all be together again, and I...
Dimitri, it's all right. Just... I can't let him live. All right, you're my family, and I'll forgive you, but Darko's done too much. He's gotten away with way too much. He's not even the real king. That Strider is supposed to be the king.
Serenity? I didn't...
Yes, you did. Mom told us all about her. Open your eyes, Dimitri. He's not even a king. We're not even royalty in the first place. Now I see what Lily meant.
I...
You know... That might be true. But as far as I'm concerned, she had it coming.
I'm sorry, Dimitri, but I've come too close. Too close to victory. Too close to achieving my goals for you to ruin them. I'm sorry, Dad. I know you are. I know.
You know, it's funny, Endy. I just wanted your mother back. But you couldn't obey me, could you? You refused. You refuse to listen to me.
You maniac! He was your son!
Velly.
Voidy?
Don't tell a single person what you're about to see.
I'm gonna rip your head off!
Voidy? Voidy? What is happening to him?
No, wait. Voidy, please, wait! Look, I haven't been in full control, okay? There's something you need to know about.
I don't care! Wait! Voidy! Endy, please, wait!
You killed my brother.
He's losing it.
Son, Endy, wait. Your mother, she...
I want you dead! She... Look, I'm sorry! I was trying to protect all of you! William is more dangerous than you think! She was trying to kill us! He was trying to... He was trying to curse the family so we would never return! Your family, our family, was stronger than he realizes, than anyone realizes. He just wants the Enderman, our Enderman family, to be dead. He cursed me, and he's had control over me for a long time. I want your mother back. But I never wanted this.
Look, Voidy, I...
You. It's always you. You always hurt people.
I can change. I can...
Where is my friends? Where is my jelly?
Jelly, why do you care for that cat so much?
She's like a daughter to me. I want to know where they are.
Jelly is dead. She died in the void. I sensed it using a stone. Look. Andy, I
say hello to Mom.
What he said, Jelly's gone. Which is sort of a sense of deja vu for me, but you know what I mean.
You need to take us to the void, Velly. You have to help me save her.
There's nothing I can do. We can't go there. We're not void protected.
If we can find the shattered void, dear, we should be able to survive there.
If I get consumed into the void, I'm haunting you. What do we tell the others then? Darko's dead. We could go and tell everybody now that everybody's free.
We'll tell them when we get them back.
Alright. See ya. Dimitri.
Yeah, that was one of my favorite memories. Just a couple of friends, you know, before it all went crazy. I learned a lot from my sons. I learned that in time, nothing really matters if you don't have people by your side. If you don't express your love when you get the chance. Did you learn anything from your daughter, Mels?
Yes. I learned that I shouldn't have left her alone. Damn it, I should have just stayed with her. Damn it, I shouldn't have tried to kill Darko. And damn it, I shouldn't have got myself to get captured. And I blame you partially.
You blame me?
Yes, I blame you. You should have stopped me. I could have been there for her. I could have been her mother. And instead I decided to be the woman that she's supposed to worship. And what did that deranged lunatic Darko do to her?
I can assure you she never really stayed by his side. I don't think she was even on his side to begin with. She grew up to be a good person. She even convinced me so as well.
I'm sorry, Enki. I just...
Hey, I get it. I miss my sons too.
Aiden and William.
Aiden, William, and Archie.
The Illager. See, I told you you'd get used to him. It was only a matter of time until you grew attached to him. I grew attached to him within the first second I met him.
Whatever changed us, Melanie. Whatever made us different.
That lunatic.
I'd say she's got a point.
That voice.
Yeah, I get it. That voice. Hey, Mels. Miss me?
No, I don't miss you! You lied to me! You had a promise and then you... I'm gonna slap the crap out of you when I get out of these chains!
I can assure you that you should probably wait until we're out of the chains. Everything hurts.
Ugh, calm down. I'm here to save you, jeez.
Don't you touch me, you traitor! I know your games, Thrashy! I played those games before!
Melanie, look. I only broke your promise because... Look, it's been hard.
You and I both know the meteor was more safer if separated and away from him. No matter if he got that meteor or not, I stopped him from having the full thing. Even if back then, your daughter and all her friends hadn't saved the meteor and saved Andy? If they hadn't managed to do that, he would have used the meteor and realized he was missing a piece. My piece. The Void Heart. The Heart of the Void Sea, if you want to call it. God, that stupid name's complicated. Now, your daughter and her friends may have saved them, but they hadn't. Well, what I did would have saved them. Maybe not Andy, but it would have at least saved Aladoria and all of Adonia. So, think twice before getting mad at me for something that I tried to prevent.
Wait. Are you still letting that maniac tell you what to do?
Who? Darko? No, he never told me what to do before or anything.
No, Thrashy. You know who I'm talking about. Are you letting them tell you what to do?
Them? Yeah. No, I'm not.
Good. Because your daughter may be dead, but your grandson, he cares for you.
Do you want to come with me to the Void or not? Your daughter's there. So I'd suggest you make this answer pretty quick.
You better not hurt anyone.
I've got a whole set of friends there that I've yet to hurt. If I really wanted to hurt them, I think I would have done it by now. Now let's get these chains off of you guys. Alrighty. And, there. It's done.
Okay, so how am I alive? He literally killed me.
Darko used to have a strange hidden ability. Manipulation. He manipulated Necro into reviving you.
Okay, well that's just fair. From jail?
Yes, from jail. You know, I don't exactly know how Darko does these things, alright?
Wasn't that your job?
Well, I gave you a job and you didn't do it.
She just about roasted every guardian ever.
Wow, gee, thanks.
Come with me to that portal over there. You guys will get to meet a very, very wide variety of people. Let's go then, I suppose. And as for you, Melanie, I'm sorry.
Well, I'm sorry, but I can't take your forgiveness yet, or your apology. Sometimes it's hard to tell whether you're lying or not. Sometimes it feels like I'm talking to two separate thrashies. One, a good man, and the other, a pawn for some stupid eyeball robot thing. He is gone. They are gone, right?
Yes, yes, they're gone.
Well, then I'll keep my mouth shut around them in case you've gained their trust and wouldn't want them knowing. But you better tell them the truth. Because if you don't, I will.
I can't continue lying to them anymore. I can't. No, don't you backsass me, you stupid set of dead souls. What do you mean I have to kill the Calamity? I can't! One of them is my... Look, I... Okay. I'll stop back-sassing you. That's really how you're gonna freaking word it. Yeah, what do you mean I'm back-sassing you? You wanna stop acting like my parent? Okay. Okay. I'll assign someone, an assassin. She has black hair, purple skin. She should be able to do it. And if she doesn't, come up with a better plan than killing people I care for. I know I'm not allowed to care for people, right? Apparently I'm not anymore. Yes, your majesties and magicies and magistos and whoever the hell you are, I'll stop back-sassing you. Get out of my mind! Hello? Oh, hell yeah, he listened to me. They listened to me. Wow. Gotta get used to the fact that there's multiple of them now. I really, really, really hope that he doesn't hurt them. That he doesn't hurt him.